In this recipe, I am using some pre-cooked mutton pieces which I have already cooked along with some ginger garlic paste, some turmeric and some. I have a stick of cinnamon, two cardamoms, one black cardamom and two bay leaves. Garam masala has become a little brownish in color. In goes some finely chopped onions. This I'm adding some ginger and garlic paste. And cook till the rawness of ginger and garlic goes and you get a nice aroma of ginger and garlic. This is 2 pounds of mutton which I have already cooked along with about half a teaspoon of garlic paste, 1 teaspoon of ginger paste and half a teaspoon of turmeric powder and about half a teaspoon of salt, not much. And along with the mutton pieces I'm adding the dry spices. Half a teaspoon of cumin powder, one teaspoon of coriander powder, half a teaspoon of turmeric powder, and half a teaspoon of red chili powder. You can add red chili powder to your taste. If you want it very spicy, then you can add a little more. And give it a good mix. And to this, I'll be adding some yogurt. So I have brought the heat down to low. And I'm adding about 3 tablespoons of yogurt. Give it a good mix. And to this I'm adding some soaked kasuri methi. This is 3 tablespoons of kasuri methi which I have soaked. As soon as you add the kasuri methi, it gives a nice, very, very nice aroma in fact. After 5 minutes, this is done. I'm going to add the mutton stock. After adding the stock, I'm going to cook it further. Till the gravy is reduced. I want it to be a little thicker, but then the thickness depends on your taste. Curry is ready now. This is the right consistency for me. I'm adding a couple of tablespoons of fresh cream. I have added about 6 tablespoons of fresh cream to it. And that's it, this is ready. Mutton methi malai is ready. The aroma of kasuri methi and the creaminess from the fresh cream and then again the flavor of mutton pieces are really, really wonderful. Do try this very aromatic and very creamy mutton recipe and don't forget to let me know about it. We will meet next time. Till then, bye-bye.